Well, everyone, we get to finally talk about another video game this time around. Now, I pretty much only have been talking about video game consoles. I've reviewed the Wii and every single, I've owned every console for the most part. And I think the last time I've talked about a video game before Cyberpunk was, I think, Super Mario 64 on my second channel, which was like 2 years ago. So now we're going to talk about Wii Sports. I have a ton of these games that I have to get through. And here's the thing, Wii Sports, I used to play this game so much when I was like much younger. I didn't get the Wii until about 2009 when I got, you know, the second generation of the Wii that didn't have backwards compatibility with the GameCube, which is so annoying. But I think with Wii Sports, it was a very good game to showcase exactly what the Wii was going through and the new features that this specific console brought. Now, the funny thing is, this is actually one of the best-selling games of all time. Like, not the best-selling, like, Wii game. It is one of the best-selling games of all time, which is crazy. And I think that has a lot to do with a lot of these games being paired with the Wii console at the time. And also, like, the Wii remote, that was another big thing. Anytime I went over to, like, you know, GameStop, I would actually see that, you know, that game specifically being, you know, offered with the Wii remote, which was another crazy thing as well. So now, booting up the game, I don't want to make this video super long, but essentially, you know, this game is breaking down into a couple of different portions. You have to use the Wii remote and all of its functionality and all of its movement, so that's another pretty big thing to keep in mind. So there's five games here. There's tennis, baseball, bowling, golf, and boxing. Now, unfortunately, I was not able to play the boxing game because I didn't have the Wii nunchuck thing available, so that I couldn't play, but I played it when I was younger and it was a pretty cool game. Like, I liked being able to do it. I honestly don't remember it too much, but the tennis, baseball, bowling, and golf, I'm gonna tell you right now, these games are very fun, but there's just something about playing them with the Wii remote which is kind of annoying, and I can see why with their next generation, which I think was like a Wii Sports Resort, was a little bit of an improvement for sure. So starting off, like with tennis, for example, you know, you basically go ahead, boot up the game as normal. You get to choose how many players you're playing with. In this case, I was only playing by myself, and that's a big thing to keep in mind. All these games I was playing by myself against the machine. So again, keep that in mind while I go through this. Now with tennis, I think tennis was a really cool game. You know, you can go ahead and play it with up to four players, which is really awesome. Serving it was a little annoying, and I didn't get the, you know, hang of actually hitting the ball back and forth, but I think it's a pretty cool game. You know, I think for like a mini game, it's pretty awesome, and I think that's kind of how this whole entire, you know, game itself, Wii Sports, it just feels like a bunch of mini games, which I actually like. A lot of these, like I mentioned, got bundled up with Wii's, so it really was there just to showcase to you what was compatible and what was capable. Now, one thing that really threw me off is that during the tennis game, when they replayed it, you know, it actually looked pretty high-definite, which was actually pretty impressive. Now, that was essentially it for the tennis game. I liked it. It wasn't really too hard besides the controls getting used to it, but other than that, it felt perfectly fine. Now, I did go ahead and play bowling next, which I can tell you right now, this game was kind of difficult as well. There's some things with the Wii remote that kind of threw me off, but again, I played by myself, and I actually didn't do that bad. It was towards the ending that I just didn't get the hang of it there, but I think bowling was actually pretty fun as well. Like, it really wasn't that bad. And then we switched over to golfing, which also golfing was probably more annoying than anything else. You have the bar at the side. You have to hold down with A if you want to go ahead and swing to it, but you pretty much just, you can change the putter and everything by clicking the arrow keys, but you go ahead and get ready to hit the ball at the bottom. But there's something with the Wii sensor bar and all these other things that really threw me off as well when I was younger, and since I was emulating it this time, using my keys, it was much easier to do it, which I was so surprised about. But again, getting used to it and actually hitting the specific ball, like, I'm not gonna say I was a pro or anything, and it is kind of like a cheat when you're using an emulator when you can just go ahead and just kind of keep it in the same portion so it really doesn't, you know, move around in the Wii remote settings. But I think, again, golfing probably takes a little bit more skill than all these other ones because you do have to stay in the same position, and it is actually pretty hard. But I will tell you, the game that threw me off the hardest was the baseball one, I think even more than the tennis one. So with the baseball one, essentially it's the same exact thing. You go ahead and just hit it like a, you know, a regular baseball, but I would just strike out so much, you know, and it's weird because the ball is not being thrown exactly the same portion, and the Wii remote has to be at the same, you know, level as the ball essentially. So it's crazy how accurate the Wii remote is. You know, it can detect exactly where you are in terms of the sensor bar, and I think that's another really cool thing that Wii Sports had going for it. And those were essentially all of the games that this thing had. And here's the thing, with this specific console, I mean, this was one of the first games that came out for the Wii. You know, it was kind of like a showcase of what was capable. It's almost like Zelda Breath of the Wild before the Wii. And that really went into play because it was one of the best-selling Wii games of all time, but also one of the best-selling games of all time as well. And this game had high ratings for sure. I mean, when I was younger, like I mentioned, I remember hearing about it and I played with it. And I think even now, I mean, just the capability of this game is still super impressive, but it really isn't perfect. I think, in my opinion, like I mentioned mentioned before, the reason I mentioned that I was playing by myself and I didn't have other people, first of all, I don't know anybody else who would play this with me. But second of all, I suck at sports in real life as well, so I suck at these games, which is okay, you can suck at these games. But I really do think if you're going to play these games by yourself right now in 2021, and whether it's still worth playing, I think it is worth playing, but I think you're going to get the most fun if you play with multiple people. You know, I look at games like, you know, like Super Smash, for example, like, you know, even with the Ultimate, even before with like the Wii U version and stuff, Wii U, you can play by yourself and still have a really good time playing against, you know, like the stock enemies, you know, against the PC. You can have a really good experience with that. But there's just something about playing, you know, these type of games against the computer here. In this example, it's just not as fun. You know, I think when you have like multiple people, even two other people, and you either you're on the same team or against each other, it makes it much more competitive. I feel like in this specific game, it's not as fun with one person as two. Whereas, you know, if you're playing like Super Smash, like it's not like way more fun if you're playing with more people. Like obviously it is kind of, but you can still have a really, really good time if you're playing against the computer. In this specific case, I just really wasn't having that good of a time playing against the computer, to be honest. But I do remember when I was younger playing against this game and playing against these computers, it was a lot of fun. You know, it was so much fun for sure. And I'm gonna tell you, I mean, there's a reason this game is like number one everywhere. This is one of the most popular games of all time. It probably is still being sold at like GameStop and a lot of these other places for sure, mostly because they became bundled with a lot of the Wii remotes. So I think for sure when it comes down to it, and this is one of the best games of all time, this is a great, you know, game for me to get started with, a still worth playing series if I'm going to go into it even further, mostly because this is a game that people grew up with in their childhood for sure. I mean, this game came out in 2006. There's probably people who are watching and listening to this video who are younger than how old this game is, you know? I mean, it's crazy. So I think Wii Sports holds a special dear place in a lot of people's hearts. And I think even now in this day and age, this game is very perfect. You know, it's very cool. I'm glad that Wii Sports Resort came out and the other one came out for the Wii U. I'm really happy about it. And I think this game is still worth playing for sure. But I do want to say it's more fun. It's probably only worth it if you're playing with multiple different people. You know, I think if you're playing with more than one person, I think right then it gets a little bit more fun. But even now, I think it's still a really good game for sure. So that essentially covers it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.